Blackstone presents The Mad, Mad Murders of Marigold Way, a novel by Raymond Benson. This book is read by Joe Barrett. For Randy, I am so glad it was you with whom I spent the lockdown. Author's note: this book was written between May and September 2020, while the uncertainty of the coronavirus pandemic, among other stressors, placed every soul on the planet on edge. While it began in March that year with a mandatory lockdown enforced in most places, it became more of a self-regulated quarantine over the summer. Even at the time of this writing, nearly 2 years later, the end doesn't appear to be anywhere in sight. Every author has influences for various works. For this one, I seem to have embraced the Americana of Thornton Wilder, the twisted domestic tales of Tom Perrotta, and the quirky dark humor sensibility of the Coen brothers. While this story is assuredly a bit of fever dream absurdity, its creation was, at the very least, personally therapeutic. Stay sane, safe, and well. R.B. Spring 2022. 1. Friends, this is a little tale about some murders. It takes place in a stereotypical American suburb on a familiar American street, not too far northwest, but far enough from a major American metropolitan center, Chicago, Illinois. For our purposes, we'll call our suburb Lincoln Grove, although its name, as well as the names of the characters involved, has been changed to protect... I don't know. Changing names isn't going to protect anyone. While no murders make much sense, these are truly wacky. I like to call them the Mad, Mad Murders of Marigold Way. Our story is set in May 2020. This is significant, for the entire world was under the thumb of this thing called COVID-19, the coronavirus. I'm sure you've heard about it. I imagine every single human being on the planet is well aware of the pandemic that has altered our way of life, no matter if you're rich, poor, smart, or stupid. Therefore, I ask you to place yourself back to that month. From here on out, we are no longer using past tense to refer to May 2020. It is now. In most of America, especially in the cities and surrounding suburbs, folks are staying home. Unless you're one of those brave, essential workers, you've been working from home using computers, phones, and that newfangled Zoom technology. Or maybe you aren't working at all. Perhaps you are one of the unfortunate ones who got furloughed, a nice way to say laid off, or even outright fired. If that's the case, then I'm sorry, my friend. This situation has created a new kind of existence for everyone, right? No more gatherings of clusters of people, no more concerts or movies or live theater, no more shopping malls. Restaurants are starting to reopen, but who really wants to be served a meal by someone wearing a mask? Kind of takes the fun out of dining out. The isolation is beginning to take a toll on some. The media says that reports of domestic violence have increased, drug abuse is rampant, and depression and insomnia are common ailments. Whether you're a Democrat or a Republican, the news from Washington, D.C. is never pleasant. I don't want to bring politics into our yarn, but it's impossible to allow it to unfold without the background of the coronavirus informing our characters and what they do. If this were a stage play, perhaps the set design would contain subtle representations of those ugly tennis ball-like things with the suction spikes sticking out of it. The germ, as depicted under a microscope. Yuck. I don't know about you, but I don't like the looks of that thing. Speaking of a stage play, you folks might remember one by a playwright named Thornton Wilder. It was entitled Our Town, and it was first produced way back in 1938. It's a hugely popular slice of Americana, a Pulitzer Prize-winning play, and it's been done to death with revivals, movies, TV adaptations, and hundreds of high school and college productions. I was in one myself in my college years. I played Simon Stimson, the town's choirmaster and resident alcoholic. And who am I, you ask? That is a good question, but one I'm not likely to answer during the course of our adventure together. In Wilder's Our Town, the main character is really a narrator, a fellow who walks around the stage and comments on the people and the action, addressing the audience directly and becoming their friend. In the program, he is called the stage manager. Well, I'd like you to think of me as something like that. Yes, I am your humble narrator, that omniscient presence hovering over the story, a persona who, I hope, will become your friend and confidant, too. I'm male, and old enough that Central Casting would likely consider me to play someone's grandfather, so maybe those tidbits will help you form a picture of me in your head. Furthermore, in keeping with the conceit of a storyteller, you should be aware that, yes, I do know things about our murders that you don't, and I know things the characters don't. I call those things the missing pieces. Ask any good homicide cop if a closed case is ever fully complete. The answer is liable to be no. A prosecutor might have all the evidence one needs to successfully convict a killer in a courtroom, but there are almost always pieces of the puzzle that are missing. A crime's physical evidence might suggest a timeline of events.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.